Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to help you understand if the man you're with or the man you're interested in is manipulating you. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with conscious, heart-centered, successful, ambitious women how you can attract the man you want and step into the most fulfilling relationship of your life so far through being your best, most feminine, most radiant self. Now, the question today, whether a guy you're with or a guy you're interested in is manipulating you, is not one that I take lightly. Why? Because there's gonna be the side of the guy who has an agenda, who has his will, he has his sense of control, and then there's you, who can either allow the manipulation to take place, or if you're not aware of it, can allow it to take place, and then can really limit and punch your life in a way that's super unfulfilling. Now, what is manipulation? In the specific context I'm talking about right now is where, with a guy specifically, is where a guy wants a specific thing from you. Whether it's good for you or not is irrelevant to him. And many times it's not good for you, but it's good for him. So he's going to use different tactics, including fear, including intimidation, including guilt, including shame, including instilling in you a false sense of duty or obligation about what you have to do in order to be acceptable, in order to be whole, in order to be loved or admired or wanted by him. Now, when you come into a relationship from a place of fear and with a sense of self that is challenged, then this is far more easy to take place. So what I'm going to share right now with you is different categories of being so that you can recognize for yourself if the man that you're interested in or the man you're with is employing any of these things with you, whether he's conscious of it or not, so you can be the woman you want to be and enter a fulfilling relationship and move away from one that's not healthy or helpful towards you. The first area that I want you to be aware of, and these are areas that only you can really make the determination about what's true and what's not true for you, is how valuable you are to the world. So what does this mean? This means that a man may try to share with you that you are less valuable if you don't do certain things, that you're less valuable if you don't act a certain way with him, if you don't open yourself emotionally or sexually with him. And if you buy into it, if you don't have a strong sense of self, then you might put away, you might give away your sense of self, your sense of worth to the man, to the point where you need his validation, and you're gonna do the things he wants you to do in order to maintain that validation from him that you're self-worthy. That's the first one, and I mention right now because it's so prevalent. When you don't have a sense of self that is strong, it's not a healthy thing to enter a relationship because it's not gonna be fulfilling for the most part. Second category that you need to be very aware of in terms of what a guy is saying to you and how he's using this to his advantage, maybe against you, and that is your level of intelligence. Whenever a guy uses things such as, you're so stupid, which would be a direct, disrespectful thing to say to you, but also, so stupid if you don't think this way, if you don't act this way, if you don't do the things I want you to do, and you buy into it, then the manipulation can take place. So he doesn't get to decide how intelligent you are. You get to decide that. You get to figure that out for yourself. Don't buy into someone saying that you're less intelligent if you don't act a certain way. He can disrespect, he can have a difference of opinion with you. He can value certain things and you value certain others. There's definitely metrics that are standardized that can help you at least figure out your level of IQ, if that's something that you want to figure out, but he doesn't get to make that call. Next one, and it's so important, is how beautiful you are. Sometimes when a man wants to have you be at his control, he will say things to you that, if you don't pay close attention, will make you feel less beautiful, will make you feel less attractive, less magnetic, less sexy. So be very aware of a guy who steps into your life and uses your beauty as a carrot for you to do certain things. And when he doesn't get his way, then he shares that your beauty is not up to par, so that you, in a weird, twisted way, feel like, well, but almost like he's doing you a favor to be with you. The next one is very related to the previous one, which is beauty, which is ideal weight. Many men who have a specific low self-worth, need to control, were wounded when they were children, maybe were beaten up too many times, will find a way to to make you feel, if you accept it, if you take it, like there's something wrong with your weight. Like you should be on a diet, like you should be eating less, like you should be doing more exercise, that you should be avoiding certain things so that he continues finding you attractive. Be very, very weary of someone who is using your weight against you or your weight in order to get you to take certain actions that may be very unhealthy for you. You might be in an incredible weight, you might have incredible curves, and if he doesn't like them, that's his thing. You need to be able to figure out for yourself what is healthy and what is needed in terms of movement, exercise, nutrition. But again, he doesn't get to make that call for you. Next one, and again, I'm escalating this because when guys start venturing into this, this is something that you should be, this is a red giant flag. How difficult it would be for you to walk away from him. When a guy starts using techniques, strategies, conversations, of the sort of like, if you leave me, life will be shit for you, that is going to be a very controlling, the opposite of empowering thing a guy can say to you. If he really loves you and you want to leave, he'll help you leave. But if he wants to hold you captive to his thoughts, his feelings, his ideas of the world, and you start developing your own sense of worth, your own sense of here's what I need to do to be free and independent and a sovereign human being. And the moment he feels that, he gets scared and he starts sharing with you how difficult it will be for you and what a bad decision it would be for you to walk away from him because he's the best thing for you. That's a red flag that you should lift up very strongly and pay attention to. The next one is related, but it's not necessarily the same, which is how much someone else can love you. Again, he doesn't get to make that call. Many men, when they are at their wit's end and they have nothing left to say to you because they know they have failed every freaking test, from emotional connection to being open with you, to being honorable and honest, to having the masculinity to step up into life and provide something of value to you, when they fail in all the ways and you are figuring out a way to become independent from him, they may say to you that no one else will love you the way he loves you. And here's what they get you. My dear, you need to be pay close attention. When you have a strong sexual connection with him, a strong sexual chemistry with him, do not confuse that with love. Because if you confuse it with love, whenever he shares with you, no one else will love you the way I do, you will say, well, yeah, I haven't had this chemistry with anyone. Therefore, this is love. Therefore, if I leave him, I will never feel this way. It's complete and utter bullshit. You can feel equal or greater sense of pleasure, passion, excitement, fulfillment. But imagine if you took away the downs and the dips and the shame and all that stuff. It could be into a very, very healthy relationship. So again, a guy who shares with you that no one else will love you as much as he can, that's a scary thought for you. You should really, really consider if this man is the best thing for you. The last thing I want to share with you today is I want you to pay close attention. When you are taking actions in life, are you taking actions based on what you believe to be best for yourself? Or are you taking action based on not experiencing pain from him? What is your level of confidence, your level of self-love, your level of emotional inner peace and groundedness and safety when you're with him? Are you mostly feeling a soap opera up and down feeling of explosive passion with no sustainability and groundedness? Or are you feeling healthy, committed, empowering, inspirational way of acting and being that results from your decisions and your cognition and your own sovereign feelings, thoughts, and actions? No one, no man can give you the love, the validation, the respect that you won't get for yourself. So if you're not experiencing it from someone, it's time to take a step back and figure out what you need to do for yourself so you can set the boundaries and the healthy example that will show someone how to love and respect you the right way. If you find this is helpful, useful, and insightful, I'm gonna ask you to do one thing. On the first link in the description of this video, I created a class that can help you understand how to step into the best relationship of your life with a lot less pain and with a lot more ease than before. All you have to do is click on that link, enter your name and email, and you'll be redirected to that free class right away. If you like this video, click thumbs up, like, and subscribe to my channel so you can watch new episodes as they come out. And last but not least, if you find that this is something helpful to you and you recognize that watching a video will help you understand things but may not make you take action that you need, and you want hand-holding and you want accountability and you want strategy and you want help and support, second link in the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. And if we're a fit, I can handhold you and take you through the process so you can step into the relationship you want through being your best and most authentic self. Thank you so much for connecting with me today. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.